अस्सलाम वालेकुम, मैं हूं आपका होस्ट सलीम बिन मोहम्मद रफ़ी और यह है मेरी यूट्यूब चैनल। आपके पास मैं आज जो हाज़र हुआ हूं, मैं वो कलाम पाक के ऊपर मैं ये बात करना चाहता हूं कि जो ग्लोरियस कुरान, जो ये डिवाइन किताब अल्लाह ताला ने हमें हुज़ूर पाक मोहम्मद मुस्तफ़ा सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के वही की सूरत में उन पर नाजिल की और वो हम तक पहुँचाई, और उन्होंने हुज़ूर पाक ने किस तरीके से उसको हज़रत जिब्राईल अलैहिस्सलाम उनको आकर पढ़ाते रहे, उसको आपने याद किया यानी हिफ़्ज़ कर लिया, और फिर उसको हज़रत अबू बकर सिद्दीक़ रज़ी अल्लाह ताला अन्हु से किस तरह कहा कि अबू बकर इसको इस तरह से जिस तरह से मुझे हज़रत जिब्राईल अलैहिस्सलाम ने कहा है इस तरह से इसको अरेंज करो, जिस तरह से पई पहली आई थी सूरह अलक उस तरह से नहीं करो, बल्कि तुम सूरह अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह रब्बिल आलमीन सूरह फातिहा से जो है वो इसका आगाज़ करो। वो एक दुआ की सूरत में है और उसका जवाब जो है वो सारा कुरान है, और कुरान को अल्लाह ताला के हुक्म के मुताबिक हजूर पाक ने हज़रत अबू बकर से कहा कि अबू बकर इस कुरान को आप तहरीर कर देना चाहिए और तुम इसको तहरीर करो, यानी उसका 30 हिस्सों में 30 पारों में भी खुद बता दिया आपने हज़रत अबू बकर सिद्दीक़ को कि इसको 30 हिस्सों में करो, आगाज़ इससे करो और जो इसका एतम आखिर जो इसका है वो अऊज़ु बिरब्बिन्नास से करो, यानी ये तरतीब खुद हुज़ूर पाक ने सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम यानी हज़रत जिब्राईल अलैहिस्सलाम के कहने पर ये की, 30 बारों में इसको तकसीम किया, फिर 30 बारों के तकसीम के बाद 114 सूरतों में कुरान पाक को जो था वो उनसे कहा कि तहरीर करो। आपने फिर हज़रत उस्मान गनी रज़ी अल्लाह ताला अन्हु से कहा कि उस्मान इसको तुम तहरीर करो। तो ये हम उनका शुक्र नहीं अदा कर सकते कि ये दो जो हुज़ूर पाक के कंपेनियन थे, जो असाबा थे, इन्होंने हमारे ऊपर कितना एहसान किया, और ख़ास तौर पे मैं हज़रत उस्मान गनी रज़ी अल्लाह ताला अन्हु का नाम दोबारा लेना चाहता हूँ। ये नहीं कि हज़रत अली या और कोई इनसे उनके जो कंट्रीब्यूशन हैं कम हैं, लेकिन उन्होंने कम अज़ कम कुरान पाक को तरतीब दिया, उसको इस किताब की सूरत में लाए, जो आज तक वही किताब आएगी और क़यामत तक यही कुरान पाक जो है हम पर वो हम पढ़ेंगे, हम उसको हिफ़्ज़ करेंगे, रिसाइट करेंगे, और मेरी नज़र में ये एक इतना बड़ा एहसान है उम्मत रसूलुल्लाह के लिए, तमाम मुसलमानों के लिए। अहले तशी हैं वो, अहले सुन्नत हैं, यानी वो किसी भी फ़िरके से उनका ताल्लुक है जो मुसलमान है। तो ये इस अल्फाज के साथ मैं कहता हूँ कि कुरान पाक में ही कई दफ़ा ऐसे अल्फाज आएंगे, ऐसी आयात आएंगी जहाँ जो सजदा तलावत जो है वो वाजिब है, जिसे हम यानी मैंडेटरी प्रोस्ट्रेशन कहते हैं, वो हर इस पारे के आगाज़ में आपको बता दिया जाएगा कि इसमें ये सजदा तलावत आने वाला है, ताकि उस जगह जब आप तलावत करते हुए पहुँचें तो वहाँ सजदा कर लें, इशारे से कर लें। और अगर कहीं किसी महफल में गए हुए जहाँ कुरान पाक पढ़ रहे हैं, तो अगर मौका मिले तो ज़मीन पे जैसे सजदा करते हैं वैसे कर लें, बिस्मिल्लाह अल्लाहु अकबर कह लें, और ये ज़रूर करें। और पहला मैं सिर्फ इतना अर्ज़ कर दूँ कि जो सजदा है वो 9वें सिपारे में आएंगे, और ये 27वें और 30वें सिपारे में 2-2 सजदे आएंगे, 19वें भी 2 आएंगे। तो ये आपको जब आप उसको सुनेंगे ऑडियो सिपारों की, तो उसमें पहले आपको ये बता दिया जाएगा कि इसमें आयात कितनी है और इसके अंदर जो है वो सूरतें कितनी हैं और इसके अंदर सजदा तलावत कहाँ आएगा। इन अल्फाज के साथ मैं आपसे कहूँगा कि क्योंकि हम जब भी हुज़ूर पाक का जिक्र हो, क्योंकि ये हुज़ूर पाक पे वही आई थी, हम उनकी दुरूद व सलाम उनको भेजते हैं, यानी उनको जो सैल्यूटेशन जिससे है जो मैंडेटरी है वो भी हम दिल से करते हैं। तो मैं चाहता हूँ कि अब आप पीछे हटें, यानी आई वांट या यू सिट बैक एंड लिसन टू दैट दुरूद व सलाम में आप, उसके बाद आप सिपारा शुरू होगा और आप उस बारे को जाने।
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد بعدد من صلى وصام وصلي كذلك على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى الملائكة المقربين وعلى عباد الله الصالحين وعلى صاحب الحياء وناشر القرآن الشهيد المظلوم حين تلاوة الفرقان عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه.
میں یہاں یہ عرض کروں کہ حضرت عثمان غنی رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ اور حضرت ابو بکر صدیق رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ اور حضرت عمر فاروق رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ اور حضرت علی رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ ان کا چاروں اصحابہ کا حسب نسب ایک ہی تھا. ان کے آباؤ اجداد کو اگر آپ ان کے لڑی کو دیکھیں ان کے فیملی ٹری کو دیکھیں تو سب یہ انہی بزرگوں کی اولاد تھے, تو اس لیے ایک ہی ان کا ڈی این اے اور ایک ہی وہ بلڈ چلا آ رہا تھا. اس لیے ہمارے لیے یہ چاروں بے حد مقدس, بے حد ہمارے لیے باعث عزت اور باعث فخر ہیں. حضرت عثمان غنی حضرت علی کی طرح حضور پاک کے داماد تھے, یعنی حضرت علی اور حضرت عثمان غنی رضی اللہ تعالیٰ آپس میں ہم جڑ تھے. تو میں جب یہ بات کرتا ہوں کہ ہم ان کے بے حد مشکور ہیں حضرت عثمان غنی رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ کے, کہ انہوں نے اس قرآن کو جسے ترتیب دیا تھا حضور پاک نے اس کو پرنٹ پبلش تحریر یہ سارے میں کی, اور آج تک ہم دونوں اہل تشیع اور اہل سنت اور جتنے بھی اسلام میں اگر کوئی فرقے جو کہ ہونے نہیں چاہیے لیکن ہیں تو وہ سارے وہی قرآن پڑھتے ہیں, تو اتنا بڑا احسان ہے ان کا ہمارے اوپر. تو اس لیے اب حضرت علی کا بھی کوئی کسی طرح سے ان کا درجہ یا ان کی جو امپورٹنس ہے وہ کسی سے کم نہیں ہے. ہر ایک کا اپنا اپنا حصہ ہے, اور اسلام میں ان کا ہم سارا جو قرآن پاک میں جب پڑھتے ہیں تو ہم انہی کو اسی طرح سے انہی الفاظ سے یاد کرتے ہیں. آپ کی بہادری, آپ کی جو علم تھا حضرت علی کا یا فراست تھی وہ نون ہے, تو اس لیے ہمارے لیے یہ بے حد مقدس ہیں. تو میں قرآن پاک کے لیے اب آپ کو دعوت دیتا ہوں کہ اب آپ سپارہ سنیے, اور جیسے میں نے کہا کہ اب یہ انگلش زبان میں آپ سپارہ سنیں گے اور یہ اس سے محظوظ ہوں.
29th para. The 29th para or juz of the Quran is Tabarakallazi, which has 11 surahs: Surah Al-Mulk 67, ayat 1-30, Surah Al-Kalam 68, ayat 1-52, Surah Al-Haqqah 69, ayat 1-52, Surah Al-Ma'arij 70, ayat 1-44, Surah Nuh 71, ayat 1-28, Surah Al-Jin 72, ayat 1-28, Surah Al-Muzammil 73, ayat 1-20, Surah Al-Mudassir 74, ayat 1-56, Surah Al-Qiyamah 75, ayat 1-40, Surah Ad-Dahar 76, ayat 1-31, and Surah Al-Mursalat 77, ayat 1-50. Total no of ayat in this para, 431.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Blessed be he in whose hands is dominion, and he over all things has power. He who created death and life, that he may try which of you is best indeed, and he is the exalted in might, oft forgiving. He who created the seven heavens, one above another, no want of proportion will you see in the creation of Allah most gracious. So turn your vision again. See you any flaw? Again turn your vision a second time. Your vision will come back to you dull and discomforted, in a state worn out. And we have from of old adorned the lowest heaven with lamps, and we have made such lamps as missiles to drive away the evil ones, and have prepared for them the penalty of the blazing fire. For those who reject their Lord and Cherisher is the penalty of hell, and evil is such destination. When they are cast therein, they will hear the terrible drawing in of its breath, even as it blazes forth. Almost bursting with fury, Every time a group is cast therein, its keepers will ask, "Did no warner come to you?" They will say, "Yes, indeed, a warner did come to us, but we rejected him," and said, "Allah never sent down any message. You are in nothing but an egregious delusion." They will further say, "Had we but listened or used our intelligence, we should not now be among the companions of the blazing fire." They will then confess their sins, but far will be forgiveness from the companions of the blazing fire. As for those who fear their Lord unseen, for them is forgiveness and a great reward. And whether you hide your word or publish it, He certainly has full knowledge of the secrets of all hearts. Should He not know, He that created, and He is the one that understands the finest mysteries and is well acquainted with them. It is He who has made the earth manageable for you. So traverse you through its tracts and enjoy of the sustenance which He furnishes. But unto Him is the resurrection. Do you feel secure that He who is in heaven will not cause you to be swallowed up by the earth when it shakes as in an earthquake? Or do you feel secure that He who is in heaven will not send against you a violent tornado with showers of stones? So that you shall know how terrible was my warning. But indeed, men before them rejected my warning. Then how terrible was my rejection of them. Do they not observe the birds above them, spreading their wings and folding them in? None can uphold them except Allah most gracious. Truly, it is He that watches over all things. Nay, who is there that can help you, even as an army besides Allah most merciful, in nothing but delusion are the unbelievers? Or who is there that can provide you with sustenance if He were to withhold His provision? Nay, they obstinately persist in insolent impiety and flight from the truth. Is then one who walks headlong with his face grovelling better guided, or one who walks evenly on a straight way? Say, it is He who has created you, and made you grow, and made for you the faculties of hearing, seeing, feeling, and understanding. Little thanks it is you give. Say, it is He who has multiplied you through the earth, and to Him shall you be gathered together. They ask, when will this promise be fulfilled if you are telling the truth? Say, as to the knowledge of the time, it is with Allah alone. I am sent only to warn plainly in public. At length, when they see it close at hand, grieved will be the faces of the unbelievers. And it will be said to them, this is the promise fulfilled which you were calling for. Say, see you, if Allah were to destroy me and those with me, or if He bestows His mercy on us, yet who can deliver the unbelievers from a grievous penalty? Say, He is Allah most gracious, we have believed in Him, and on Him have we put our trust. So soon will you know which of us it is that is in manifest error. Say, see you, if your stream be some morning lost in the underground earth, who then can supply you with clear flowing water?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
نون. By the pen and by the record which men write, you are not by the grace of your Lord mad or possessed. Nay, verily for you is a reward unfailing, and you stand on an exalted standard of character. Soon will you see, and they will see, which of you is afflicted with madness. Verily, it is your Lord that knows best which among men has strayed from His path, and He knows best those who receive true guidance. So hearken not to those who deny the truth. Their desire is that you should be pliant, so would they be pliant. Heed not the type of despicable man, ready with oaths, a slanderer, going about with calumnies, habitually hindering all good, transgressing beyond bounds, deep in sin, violent and cruel, with all that base-born, because he possesses wealth and numerous sons. When to him are rehearsed our signs, tales of the ancients, he cries, Soon shall we brand the beast on the snout. Verily, we have tried them as we tried the people of the garden, when they resolved to gather the fruits of the garden in the morning, but made no reservation if it be Allah's will. Then there came on the garden a visitation from your Lord, which swept away all around while they were asleep. So the garden became, by the morning, like a dark and desolate spot, whose fruit had been gathered. As the morning broke, they called out one to another, "Go you to your tilth betimes in the morning, if you would gather the fruits." So they departed, conversing in secret low tones, saying, "Let not a single indigent person break in upon you into the garden this day." And they opened the morning, strong in an unjust resolve. But when they saw the garden, they said, "We have surely lost our way. Indeed, we are shut out of the fruits of our labor." Said one of them, "More just than the rest, did I not say to you, why not glorify Allah?" They said, "Glory to our Lord, verily we have been doing wrong." Then they turned, one against another, in reproach. They said, "Alas for us, we have indeed transgressed. It may be that our Lord will give us in exchange a better garden than this, for we do turn to Him in repentance." Such is the punishment in this life, but greater is the punishment in the hereafter, if only they knew. Verily, for the righteous are gardens of delight in the presence of their Lord. Shall we then treat the people of faith like the people of sin? What is the matter with you? How judge you? Or have you a book through which you learn, that you shall have through it whatever you choose? Or have you covenants with us on oath, reaching to the day of judgment, providing that you shall have whatever you shall demand? Ask you of them, which of them will stand surety for that? Or have they some partners in Godhead? Then let them produce their partners, if they are truthful. The day that the shank shall be laid bare, and they shall be summoned to prostrate in adoration, but they shall not be able. Their eyes will be cast down, ignominy will cover them, seeing that they had been summoned aforetime to prostrate in adoration, while they were in good shape, and had refused. Then leave me alone with such as reject this message. By degrees shall we punish them, from directions they perceive not. Long respite will I grant them. Truly powerful is my plan. Or is it that you do ask them for a reward, so that they are burdened with a load of debt? Or that the unseen is in their hands, so that they can write it down? So wait with patience for the command of your Lord, and be not like the companion of the fish when he cried out in agony. Had not grace from his Lord reached him, he would indeed have been cast off on the naked shore in disgrace. Thus did his Lord choose him and make him of the company of the righteous. And the unbelievers would almost trip you up with their eyes when they hear the message, and they say, "Surely he is possessed." But it is nothing less than a message to all the worlds.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
The sure reality. What is the sure reality? And what will make you realize what the sure reality is? The Thamud and the Ad people branded as false the stunning calamity. But the Thamud, they were destroyed by a terrible storm of thunder and lightning. And the Ad, they were destroyed by a furious wind exceedingly violent. He made it rage against them 7 nights and 8 days in succession, so that you could see the whole people lying prostrate in its path, as if they had been roots of hollow palm trees tumbled down. Then see you any of them left surviving? And Pharaoh, and those before him, and the cities overthrown, committed habitual sin, and disobeyed each the messenger of their Lord. So he punished them with an abundant penalty. We, when the water of Noah's flood overflowed beyond its limits, carried you mankind in the floating ark, that we might make it a message unto you, and that ears that should hear the tale and retain its memory should bear its lessons in remembrance. Then, when one blast is sounded on the trumpet, and the earth is moved, and its mountains, and they are crushed to powder at one stroke, on that day shall the great event come to pass, and the sky will be rent asunder, for it will that day be flimsy, and the angels will be on its sides, and eight will that day bear the throne of your Lord above them. That day shall you be brought to judgment. Not an act of yours that you hide will be hidden. Then he that will be given his record in his right hand will say, "Ah, here, read you my record. I did really understand that my account would one day reach me." And he will be in a life of bliss, in a garden on high, the fruits whereof will hang in bunches low and near. Eat you and drink you with full satisfaction, because of the good that you sent before you in the days that are gone. And he that will be given his record in his left hand will say, "Ah, would that my record had not been given to me, and that I had never realized how my account stood. Ah, would that death had made an end of me. Of no profit to me has been my wealth. My power has perished from me." Stern command will say, "Seize you him, and bind you him, and burn you him in the blazing fire. Further, make him march in a chain whereof the length is 70 cubits. This was he that would not believe in Allah Most High, and would not encourage the feeding of the indigent. So no friend has he here this day, nor has he any food except the corruption from the washing of wounds, which none do eat but those in sin. So I do call to witness what you see, and what you see not, that this is verily the word of an honored messenger. It is not the word of a poet, little it is you believe, nor is it the word of a soothsayer, little admonition it is you receive. This is a message sent down from the Lord of the worlds, and if the messenger were to invent any sayings in our name, we should certainly seize him by his right hand, and we should certainly then cut off the artery of his heart, nor could any of you withhold him from our wrath. But verily, this is a message for the God-fearing, and we certainly know that there are amongst you those that reject it. But truly revelation is a cause of sorrow for the unbelievers. But verily, it is truth of assured certainty. So glorify the name of your Lord Most High.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
The questioner asked about a penalty to befall the unbelievers, the which there is none to ward off. A penalty from Allah, Lord of the ways of ascent. The angels and the spirit ascend unto him in a day, the measure whereof is as 50,000 years. Therefore do you hold patience, a patience of beautiful contentment. They see the day indeed as a far-off event, but we see it quite near, the day that the sky will be like molten brass, and the mountains will be like wool, and no friend will ask after a friend. Though they will be put in sight of each other, the sinner's desire will be, would that he could redeem himself from the penalty of that day by sacrificing his children, his wife and his brother, his kindred who sheltered him, all that is on earth, so it could deliver him. By no means, for it would be the fire of hell, plucking out his being right to the skull, inviting all such as turn their backs and turn away their faces from the right, and collect wealth and hide it from use. Truly, man was created very impatient, fretful when evil touches him, and niggardly when good reaches him. Not so those devoted to prayer, those who remain steadfast to their prayer, and those in whose wealth is a recognized right. For the needy who asks, and him who is prevented for some reason from asking, and those who hold to the truth of the day of judgment, and those who fear the displeasure of their Lord. For their Lord's displeasure is the opposite of peace and tranquility, and those who guard their chastity, except with their wives and the captives whom their right hands possess, for then they are not to be blamed. But those who trespass beyond this are transgressors. And those who respect their trusts and covenants, and those who stand firm in their testimonies, and those who guard the sacredness of their worship, such will be the honored ones in the gardens of bliss. Now, what is the matter with the unbelievers that they rush madly before you, from the right and from the left, in crowds? Does every man of them long to enter the garden of bliss? By no means, for we have created them out of the base matter they know. Now I do call to witness the Lord of all points in the east and the west, that we can certainly substitute for them better men than they, and we are not to be defeated in our plan. So leave them to plunge in vain talk and play about until they encounter that day of theirs which they have been promised, the day whereon they will issue from their sepulchres in sudden haste, as if they were rushing to a goalpost fixed for them. Eyes lowered in dejection, ignominy covering them all over. Such is the day the which they are promised.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
We sent Noah to his people with the command, "Do you warn your people before there comes to them a grievous penalty?" He said, "O my people, I am to you a warner, clear and open, that you should worship Allah, fear Him, and obey Me. So He may forgive you your sins and give you respite for a stated term. For when the term given by Allah is accomplished, it cannot be put forward, if you only knew." He said, "O my Lord, I have called to my people night and day, but my call only increases their flight from the right. And every time I have called to them that you might forgive them, they have only thrust their fingers into their ears, covered themselves up with their garments, grown obstinate, and given themselves up to arrogance." So I have called to them aloud. Further, I have spoken to them in public and secretly in private, saying, "Ask forgiveness from your Lord, for He is oft forgiving. He will send rain to you in abundance, give you increase in wealth and sons, and bestow on you gardens, and bestow on you rivers of flowing water. What is the matter with you, that you place not your hope for kindness and long-suffering in Allah, seeing that it is He that has created you in diverse stages? See you not how Allah has created the seven heavens, one above another, and made the moon a light in their midst, and made the sun as a glorious lamp? And Allah has produced you from the earth, growing gradually. And in the end, He will return you into the earth, and raise you forth again at the resurrection. And Allah has made the earth for you as a carpet spread out, that you may go about therein in spacious roads." Noah said, "O my Lord, they have disobeyed Me, but they follow men whose wealth and children give them no increase but only loss. And they have devised a tremendous plot. And they have said to each other, 'Abandon not your gods, abandon neither Wad, nor Suwa, neither Yakuth, nor Ya'uk, nor Nisr.' They have already misled many, and grant you no increase to the wrongdoers, but in staying from their mark. Because of their sins, they were drowned in the flood, and were made to enter the fire of punishment, and they found, in lieu of Allah, none to help them." And Noah said, "O my Lord, leave not of the unbelievers a single one on earth. For, if you do leave any of them, they will but mislead your devotees, and they will breed none but wicked ungrateful ones. O my Lord, forgive me, my parents, all who enter my house in faith, and all believing men and believing women, and to the wrongdoers grant you no increase but in perdition.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Say, it has been revealed to me that a company of jinns listened to the Quran. They said, we have really heard a wonderful recital. It gives guidance to the right, and we have believed therein. We shall not join in worship any gods with our Lord. And exalted is the majesty of our Lord. He has taken neither a wife nor a son. There were some foolish ones among us who used to utter extravagant lies against Allah. But we do think that no man or spirit should say aught that is untrue against Allah. True, there were persons among mankind who took shelter with persons among the jinns, but they increased them in folly. And they came to think as you thought, that Allah would not raise up anyone to judgment. And we pried into the secrets of heaven, but we found it filled with stern guards and flaming fires. We used, indeed, to sit there in hidden stations, to steal a hearing. But any who listens now will find a flaming fire watching him in ambush. And we understand not whether ill is intended to those on earth, or whether their Lord really intends to guide them to right conduct. There are among us some that are righteous, and some the contrary. We follow divergent paths. But we think that we can by no means frustrate Allah throughout the earth, nor can we frustrate him by flight. And as for us, since we have listened to the guidance, we have accepted it. And any who believes in his Lord has no fear, either of a short account or of any injustice. Among us are some that submit their wills to Allah, and some that swerve from justice. Now those who submit their wills, they have sought out the path of right conduct. But those who swerve, they are but fuel for hellfire. And Allah's message is, if they, the pagans, had only remained on the right way, we should certainly have bestowed on them rain in abundance, that we might try them by that means. But if any turns away from the remembrance of his Lord, he will cause him to undergo a severe penalty. And the places of worship are for Allah alone, so invoke not anyone along with Allah. Yet when the devotee of Allah stands forth to invoke him, they just make round him a dense crowd. Say, I do no more than invoke my Lord, and I join not with him any false god. Say, it is not in my power to cause you harm, or to bring you to right conduct. Say, no one can deliver me from Allah if I were to disobey him, nor should I find refuge except in him. Mine is only to convey what I receive from Allah and his messengers. For any that disobey Allah and his messenger, for them is hell, they shall dwell therein forever. At length, when they see with their own eyes that which they are promised, then will they know who it is that is weakest in his helper and least important in point of numbers. Say, I know not whether the punishment which you are promised is near, or whether my Lord will appoint for it a distant term. He alone knows the unseen, nor does he make anyone acquainted with his mysteries, except a messenger whom he has chosen, and then he makes a band of watchers march before him and behind him, that he may know that they have truly brought and delivered the messages of their Lord. And he surrounds all the mysteries that are with them and takes account of every single thing.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
O you folded in garments, stand to prayer by night, but not all night, half of it, or a little less. or a little more, and recite the Quran in slow, measured, rhythmic tones. Soon shall we send down to you a weighty message. Truly, the rising by night is most potent for governing the soul, and most suitable for framing the word of prayer and praise. True, there is for you by day prolonged occupation with manifold engagements. But keep in remembrance the name of your Lord and devote yourself to Him wholeheartedly. He is Lord of the East and the West. There is no God but He. Take Him therefore for your disposer of affairs. And have patience with what they say, and leave them with noble dignity. And leave me alone to deal with those in possession of the good things of life, who yet deny the truth, and bear with them for a little while. With us are fetters to bind them, and a fire to burn them, and a food that chokes, and a penalty grievous. One day the earth and the mountains will be in violent commotion, and the mountains will be as a heap of sand poured out and flowing down. We have sent to you, O men, a messenger, to be a witness concerning you, even as we sent a messenger to Pharaoh. But Pharaoh disobeyed the messenger, so we seized him with a heavy punishment. Then how shall you, if you deny Allah, guard yourselves against a day that will make children hoary-headed, whereon the sky will be cleft asunder? His promise needs must be accomplished. Verily, this is an admonition. Therefore, whoso will, let him take a straight path to his Lord. Your Lord does know that you stand forth to prayer nigh 2/3 of the night, or half the night, or 1/3 of the night, and so does a party of those with you. But Allah does appoint night and day in due measure. He knows that you are unable to keep count thereof. So He has turned to you in mercy. Read you therefore of the Quran as much as may be easy for you. He knows that there may be some among you in ill health, others travelling through the land, seeking of Allah's bounty, yet others fighting in Allah's cause. Read you therefore as much of the Quran as may be easy for you, and establish regular prayer, and give regular charity, and loan to Allah a beautiful loan. And whatever good you send forth for your souls, you shall find it in Allah's presence, yea, better and greater in reward. And seek you the grace of Allah, for Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
O you wrapped up in a mantle, arise and deliver your warning, and your Lord do you glorify, and your garments keep free from stain, and all abomination shun, nor expect in giving any increase for yourself, but for your Lord's cause be patient and constant. Finally, when the trumpet is sounded, that will be that day, a day of distress, far from easy for those without faith. Leave me alone to deal with the creature whom I created bare and alone, to whom I granted resources in abundance, and sons to be by his side, to whom I made life smooth and comfortable. Yet is he greedy that I should add yet more? By no means, for to our signs he has been refractory. Soon will I visit him with a mount of calamities. For he thought and he plotted, and woe to him how he plotted. Yea, woe to him how he plotted. Then he looked round. Then he frowned and he scowled. Then he turned back and was haughty. Then said he, this is nothing but magic derived from of old. This is nothing but the word of a mortal. Soon will I cast him into hellfire. And what will explain to you what hellfire is? Nought does it permit to endure and naught does it leave alone, darkening and changing the color of man. Over it are 19. And we have set none but angels as guardians of the fire, and we have fixed their number only as a trial for unbelievers, in order that the people of the book may arrive at certainty, and the believers may increase in faith, and that no doubts may be left for the people of the book and the believers, and that those in whose hearts is a disease and the unbelievers may say, "What symbol does Allah intend by this?" Thus does Allah leave to stray whom He pleases, and guide whom He pleases. And none can know the forces of your Lord except He, and this is no other than a warning to mankind. Nay, verily by the moon, and by the night as it retreats, and by the dawn as it shines forth, this is but one of the mighty portents, a warning to mankind. To any of you that chooses to press forward or to follow behind, every soul will be held in pledge for its deeds, except the companions of the right hand. They will be in gardens of delight, and will ask the sinners, "What led you into hellfire?" They will say, "We were not of those who prayed, nor were we of those who fed the indigent, but we used to talk vanities with vain talkers, and we used to deny the day of judgment, until there came to us the hour that is certain. Then will no intercession of any intercessors profit them. Then what is the matter with them that they turn away from admonition, as if they were affrighted asses, fleeing from a lion? Forsooth, each one of them wants to be given scrolls of revelation spread out. By no means, but they fear not the hereafter. Nay, this surely is an admonition. Let any who will keep it in remembrance, but none will keep it in remembrance except as Allah wills. He is the Lord of righteousness and the Lord of forgiveness."
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
I do call to witness the resurrection day, and I do call to witness the self-reproaching spirit eschew evil. Does man think that we cannot assemble his bones? Nay, we are able to put together in perfect order the very tips of his fingers. But man wishes to do wrong even in the time in front of him. He questions, "When is the day of resurrection?" At length, when the sight is dazed, and the moon is buried in darkness, and the sun and moon are joined together, that day will man say, "Where is the refuge?" By no means, no place of safety. Before your Lord alone, that day will be the place of rest. That day will man be told all that he put forward and all that he put back. Nay, man will be evidence against himself, even though he were to put up his excuses. Move not your tongue concerning the Quran to make haste therewith. It is for us to collect it and to recite it. But when we have recited it, follow you its recital. Nay more, it is for us to explain it and make it clear. Nay, you men, but you love the fleeting life, and leave alone the hereafter. Some faces that day will beam in brightness and beauty, looking towards their Lord, and some faces that day will be sad and dismal, in the thought that some back-breaking calamity was about to be inflicted on them. Yea, when the soul reaches to the collarbone in its exit, and there will be a cry, "Who is a magician to restore him?" And he will conclude that it was the time of parting, and one leg will be joined with another. That day the drive will be all to your Lord. So he gave nothing in charity, nor did he pray. But on the contrary, He rejected truth and turned away? Then did he stalk to his family in full conceit? Woe to you, O man, yea, woe! Again woe to you, O man, yea, woe! Does man think that he will be left uncontrolled without purpose? Was he not a drop of sperm emitted in lowly form? Then did he become a clinging clot. Then did Allah make and fashion him in due proportion. And of him he made two sexes, male and female. Has not he, the same, the power to give life to the dead?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Has there not been over man a long period of time when he was nothing, not even mentioned? Verily, we created man from a drop of mingled sperm in order to try him. So we gave him the gifts of hearing and sight. We showed him the way, whether he be grateful or ungrateful, rests on his will. For the rejecters, we have prepared chains, yokes, and a blazing fire. As to the righteous, they shall drink of a cup of wine mixed with kafur, a fountain where the devotees of Allah do drink, making it flow in unstinted abundance. They perform their vows, and they fear a day whose evil flies far and wide. And they feed, for the love of Allah, the indigent, the orphan, and the captive, saying, "We feed you for the sake of Allah alone. No reward do we desire from you, nor thanks. We only fear a day of distressful wrath from the side of our Lord. But Allah will deliver them from the evil of that day, and will shed over them a light of beauty and a blissful joy. And because they were patient and constant, He will reward them with a garden and garments of silk, reclining in the garden on raised thrones. They will see there neither the sun's excessive heat nor the moon's excessive cold. And the shades of the garden will come low over them, and the bunches of fruit there will hang low in humility. And amongst them will be passed round vessels of silver and goblets of crystal. Crystal clear, made of silver. They will determine the measure thereof according to their wishes. And they will be given to drink there of a cup of wine mixed with zanjabil, a fountain there called Salsabil. And round about them will serve youths of perpetual freshness. If you see them, you would think them scattered pearls. And when you look, it is there you will see a bliss and a realm magnificent. Upon them will be green garments of fine silk and heavy brocade, and they will be adorned with bracelets of silver, and their Lord will give to them to drink of a wine pure and holy. Verily, this is a reward for you, and your endeavor is accepted and recognized. It is we who have sent down the Qur'an to you by stages. Therefore be patient with constancy to the command of your Lord, and hearken not to the sinner or the ingrate among them. And celebrate the name of your Lord morning and evening. And part of the night prostrate yourself to Him, and glorify Him a long night through. As to these, they love the fleeting life, and put away behind them a day that will be hard. It is we who created them, and we have made their joints strong, but when we will, we can substitute the like of them by a complete change. This is an admonition, whosoever will, let him take a straight path to his Lord. But you will not, except as Allah wills. For Allah is full of knowledge and wisdom. He will admit to His mercy whom He will, but the wrongdoers, for them has He prepared a grievous penalty.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
By the winds sent forth, one after another, to man's profit. which then blow violently in tempestuous gusts, and scatter things far and wide. Then separate them one from another. Then spread abroad a message, whether of justification or of warning. Assuredly, what you are promised must come to pass. Then when the stars become dim, when the heaven is cleft asunder, when the mountains are scattered to the winds as dust, and when the messengers are all appointed a time to collect, for what day are these portents deferred? For the day of sorting out. And what will explain to you what is the day of sorting out? Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth. Did we not destroy the men of old for their evil? So shall we make later generations follow them. Thus do we deal with men of sin. Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth. Have we not created you from a fluid held despicable, the which we placed in a place of rest, firmly fixed, for a period of gestation, determined according to need? For we do determine according to need, for we are the best to determine things. Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth. Have we not made the earth as a place to draw together the living and the dead, and made therein mountains standing firm, lofty in stature, and provided for you waters sweet and wholesome? Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth. It will be said, depart you to that which you used to reject as false. Depart you to a shadow of smoke ascending in three columns, which yields no shade of coolness, and is of no use against the fierce blaze. Indeed, it throws about sparks huge as forts, as if there were a string of yellow camels marching swiftly. Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth. That will be a day when they shall not be able to speak, nor will it be open to them to put forth pleas. Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth. That will be a day of sorting out. We shall gather you together and those before you. Now, if you have a trick or plot, use it against me. Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth. As to the righteous, they shall be amidst cool shades and springs of water, and they shall have fruits, all they desire. Eat you and drink you to your heart's content, for that you worked righteousness. Thus do we certainly reward the doers of good. Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth.
O you unjust, eat you and enjoy yourselves but a little while, for that you are sinners.
Ah, woe that day to the rejecters of truth. And when it is said to them, prostrate yourselves, they do not so. Ah, woe, that day to the rejecters of truth. Then what message after that will they believe in?